as I see it, the purpose is really in line with the recommendations of Elliott Johnston in the Royal Commission, that we have to develop a dialogue and we have to develop a better understanding of the position of the people in the communities. I mean, no one will dispute that they've been treated badly and that the impact of the European culture has been catastrophic. Now we have to try and work out a way to make some progress and resolve those catastrophic effects.
The reason I put my hand up for the trip to the AP lands was that I have said that in the short to medium term I'd like to be a magistrate based in Port Augusta, and then I felt that it was important for me to go and have a look around and see where I'd be working. Not because I've never been there before, but because I haven't been there for a long time.
To get a real understanding of that cultural background, I really think it's necessary to be there and to see it. It's obviously the best way, rather than trying to read it in books and get an understanding in that way. It's going to be, I think, invaluable to be up there and be able to see for myself and be able to ask questions. And I'm really obviously looking on the trip as an opportunity to learn a lot about that. And I think the knowledge that I'll gain through that experience will be put to very good use in this court.
It's nice to stop. It's nice to be lovely and quiet.
So when we leave tomorrow, leave all your sleeping gear in this way and just roll it up.
You know, sometimes they don't understand. Even English, you know, English is a protocol in it. Some people go to court, you know, what that lawyer saying, see? Aboriginal Orba.
Get to know each other more, that'd be better, you know?
Well, you have a lot of them come through there, don't you? We're not the first.
Yeah.
We thought we were
going to
use the patients as
a see all these blokes coming in here. All the magistrates coming up here and looking around. It's really good to see that. So they can go back with some sort of a background of a person, like an Aboriginal person. They got to deal with that person and any other issues, they can actually see where they're coming from, you know? Yeah. It's good to see them just there. And I can't imagine them, they had them white wigs on or whatever they was, you know? I would like to ask them, what culture is that? What might offend them? But I just try to sit there and watch them and say, these blokes wear these hats and what? And they're here. I thought they were looking like cattlemen this morning, you know? They get up early. You know, I was thinking, yeah, when you look at it, they're only ordinary people. But when they put their disguise on, that's when they make the ripples, you know. And that's the ripples that can affect our communities and the lives yet to come. And magistrates are the one that can channel these people into that area. You know, we cannot, but through the courts, that's where it can be put these young people to be helped. And I would like to see the Western law and our law together coming together. If we're going to go hand to hand in the future, well, we must come together, you know. And we're going to bring back a proud young Aboriginal person sitting under the tree there, talking to family and and making spears and all that stuff, you know, and not chasing alcohol or drugs or whatever, or hitting their wives or something. We want to make that, we want to bring peace back into their thing, you know. And these blokes coming out here and actually looking at places like that, they might be able to get a better picture of the living environment, you know.
And this brings serious economic benefit to the community. So the artists, they're bringing in, you know, serious economy for the area.
It's fantastic to see an art centre like that in such a remote community. It provides a focus, I think, for the Aboriginal people in the town. It provides, it seems to me, quite a lot of work for the community, and gives them, I think, a sense of community. They're working together and producing some fantastic artwork.
All right, everybody say palya. Palya, 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 palya. Palya, palya,
palya. A dealer, if he's not consuming that smoke, he was just selling, how would you treat that? Would you just send him straight to jail?
There's different cases have different results, but if it's a lot of dealing, then it's very likely they'll go to jail.
If I'm a dealer and I'm selling to his family, once his family get killed or hanged, I'm lucky to get away.
I would hope that most judicial officers are acutely aware of the fact that the decisions that they make do have a ripple effect, do affect a much wider community, much wider family, and whenever we're making decisions about individuals, we have to remember that they are individuals, that what we're deciding is very important in their lives, but not only in their lives, but in the lives of many others who, their families, their communities, particularly out here on the lands where communities are so important. And an understanding of how the communities work, how the families work, and the Aboriginal culture is very important when you're dealing with Aboriginal people, and we deal with, sadly, too many Aboriginal people in a lot of our work.
Part of this trip is judicial education. Now, that sounds like a jingoistic word, but I wish I had some better expression. But to be quite frank, the legal system is largely ignorant of the practical problems up here, on-the-ground problems. Can I give you an example? I sat on circuit at Port Augusta in June, and there were quite a number of traditional people charged with various offences, and quite a few of them didn't appear. We had very solid information that it was raining up here. Anybody who's ever been up here once when it's rained knows, once it rains, you're stuck. There's no way of getting out. Nobody understood it.
Aboriginal people, when they come to our courts, feel ill at ease because it's an alien environment for them. They may not have been there before, and the consequences for them can be serious. I think the same thing happens for the judicial officers as well when they're dealing with Aboriginal people, particularly for the first time, because a lot of us haven't had any contact with Aboriginal people before. And we get an Aboriginal person come to our court, we don't quite know ourselves how to deal with them. And so this experience we've had over the last week has been good for us, because we've got to know Aboriginal people personally. We've spent a week with you, and we've met you and Sammy, and we've been to some of the communities, and we've seen how people live, and we learn a bit more about things that are important to you, and we understand your background and we understand your law a bit. For me, that's been a really valuable experience, and so thank you to you and all the other elders and the communities that have welcomed us, because it's given me some background that I didn't really have before. And I'll bear that in mind when I'm dealing with Aboriginal people in my court. So thank you.
It's been a very lengthy learning experience for me. It's been very important for me to come up here, not just this time, but on the previous trip that I've done. So, Lee, I've valued that chat we had and other chats we've had at various times during the trip about the kinship system and about the importance of family. This understanding I've developed quite late in my career. So I'll be going home, not just telling him what a great time I've had and how I risked my life on a camel pad and things like that, but going back to the other judges who have this, at times, very difficult exercise of deciding who children are to live with in a dispute and trying to assist them in understanding just what Indigenous culture and family means. So, personally, a big thank you, Lee.
It's all very well for people in the city to say, well, I've read a book about Aboriginal customary law and I'm aware of Aboriginal people's connection to the land and their affinity to the land. But when you see a man standing in the cave at Cave Hill, and you know that his family have been the custodians of that cave for 20,000 years, it really sent shivers down my spine to think about it.
It exceeded my expectations, I've got to say. I didn't know quite what to expect for my trip up here to the APY lands, but it is a fantastic place, and the people are fantastic. It was just a great experience. I consider myself very lucky to have had the opportunity to come up here. It's not just the people, all the people that we've met, but also the landscape is, you have to see it to believe it. You can see why they would have the attachment that they have to the land.